Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial. Today we're going to look at seamlessly blending images together in Photoshop. I've chosen three images to use, one of a pair of girls, one of what looks to be one of those girls by themselves, and a background image that I'm going to use to assemble everything on. I've chosen images all from the same photographer, which have probably all been shot in similar lighting circumstances. This will certainly help. I'm going to the layers palette and I want to assemble all of these images into my background image. So the background image is this one here. I'll right click on the background layer here, choose duplicate layer, and then choose the background image that I want to assemble them all into and click OK. So here in this middle image, I've got the background and the two girls. Now let's go and get this single girl. Same process, right click, duplicate layer, choose the image to put it into, click OK. And I have one image now with all three images in it. I'll resize these images and place them in the approximate position I want them to be in. To do this, I'm targeting the topmost image. Press Ctrl or Command T to get the transform handles, Ctrl or Command 0 to see those handles. I'll hold the Shift key because it needs to be sized in proportion so we don't skew her face out of alignment. And I'll place it roughly where I want it to be, being sure that anytime I size this image, I have the Shift key held. Now let's go to the middle selection, which is these two young girls, and I'm going to place them sort of around about here in the image. There are a couple of things to be aware of when you're placing a person. One of them is not to sort of leave them in mid-air unless you really want to do quite a bit of blending around the bottom of the image, because otherwise they're going to look like they're floating. So I am anchoring them in the bottom of the image. It will also look better if you try and create two different size images. So I chose this one because it's a large image of just a single girl, and this one's much smaller. So the contrast in size is going to work pretty well here too. Because I didn't particularly like the backgrounds of either of these images, I chose a background that would be sympathetic to the selection of images that I have. We're going to ignore this middle image for a minute and let's go to this topmost image so we can blend it. We'll add a layer mask by clicking here on the Add Layer Mask icon. While you could use the eraser tool, it's a bit heavy-handed because if you make a mistake, it's too hard to come back and undo that bit of the image that you made a mistake on. So I prefer to use masks because they're editable. We'll target the mask so it has this little border around it. Make sure that we're going to be painting in black because we want to be removing the areas of this top image to see through to the layer beneath. I'll select the brush tool. Let's see what sort of brush I have selected. Well, I want a round, soft brush. The size is pretty immaterial right now because it's very easy to adjust that. Hardness, I'm going to settle for 0% to start off with, a nice soft brush, and the opacity at 100%. At this point, I'll use the open and close square bracket keys to resize my brush, but you can use whatever tool you like to use for resizing a brush on the fly. The work that we'll now do is to soften the very edge of this image because we don't want to be able to see where this image began and ended. Having done that and having softened and removed the edge, we'll now look to blend the two images together. We'll work with a variety of opacities at this point to just soften the transition between the two images. At any time, you can press the letter X to reverse the foreground and background, and that will let you adjust between painting with black and painting with white. Painting with black on this mask will remove content from it. Painting with white will just paint it back in again. So sometimes you may want to switch to white and you may want to adjust the size of your brush. I'm looking at this sort of piece of grass through here and I'm thinking that it might look better if we could actually see this piece of grass. So I'm going to bring it back in and then switch colors and just remove the areas around it. So I'm bringing parts of both of these two images together in my final image. Now, before we go too far, let's have a look at this image. Again, add a mask to it. Again, go back to our brush. We'll settle for 100% opacity to begin with and quite a large brush and start removing this very obvious transition between the two images. Now I've got a piece in this image that I just don't like at all, so I'm going to target that image and I'm going to the spot healing brush tool and just size up my spot healing brush tool and just paint it out. I really want some green in that area, not a rather obtrusive slab of white. So let's go back to my mask, make sure that the mask is targeted. If your mask isn't targeted, you're just going to be painting in black or white on the image. So you really want to keep an eye out on that because it's very easy to do. And if you do that, you're going to have to go and wind that back. This is the kind of effect that you could use, for example, for a bride. You might have an image of the bride's bouquet and then an image of the bride herself. And you could put these two images together in a sort of collage piece that would make a nice adjunct to your bridal album work. You don't have to be really, really careful with these selections, provided you start varying the opacity of the brush. You can get a really nice transition between these images without being too fussy about how your selections are made. So I think that this is pretty good. Obviously you could do a bit more work between the two images, but something like this is a nice little presentation. There is, however, a bit of an issue in the color and sort of sharpness of the image. I'm going to look at this middle image first, so I'll target it and I'll choose layer, new adjustment layer, and I'll choose a curves adjustment and click OK. Now for my curves adjustment, I want to affect these girls here, but not the background. So I'll target this icon here, which limits the adjustment to just the girls' faces. I want to add a little bit more contrast and a little bit more lightness. So I'll drag down on the left-hand side. That just darkens the dark areas of the image, and then drag up on the right-hand side. That's going to do two things. It's going to add a little bit more contrast. It's also lightening the lighter areas of the image, so the girls are looking a little bit better perhaps against the background. Now let's go back to our layers palette. I'm going to target this face here, layer, new adjustment layer, and again go back to curves adjustment, click OK. Again, click here so that the curves adjustment only affects this image and not the others. You can see here in the layers palette that anytime that we click that little icon to limit the scope of the curves adjustment, we get this little bent arrow telling us that it's affecting only this layer and not all of the layers below, because by default a curves adjustment will affect all layers in the image and we don't want that to be the case. So let's click here to get back to my curves adjustment. For this one, I'm just going to lighten it. So I'm going to drag upwards on the curve on the right hand side, because these are the lighter pixels in the image. Just looking to brighten it a little bit, and again try and get a little bit more evenness of tones across the images. We could drag down a little bit at the other end if we wanted to just add a little bit more contrast into it. So there's a technique for blending multiple images together in Photoshop. You won't always have to select a background to put everything on, but in this case I wasn't really happy with the background of either of these images, so I chose a completely different background to use. Add layer masks to the layers that you want to blend and then work between painting in black or white, or you could even paint in grey on the layer masks. Vary the size of the brush, the hardness of the brush, and also the opacity of the brush as you paint to bring in elements from the layers below and to remove elements from the layer that you don't want to see. And as I said, this is a really good technique to use for a bridal album. It's also really good for senior portraits and the like. I hope that you've enjoyed learning these Photoshop techniques. Let us know what you think in the comments below and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.